Traders, I'm done for the day and I'm done for the week. You can see my result here. Lucky to stay in green today. Really lucky to stay in green. Well, I don't know if it's luck. Let's talk a little bit about it, whether it's luck or knowledge. But let me just say that I spent most of my day in red today and I'm very happy to get back to green territory. So just under $4,000 in green, and I'm having a very good week too. We had four trading days this week, short trading week. I started with a holiday on Monday and I had one losing day, the first one really, and then the rest were all in green. So I'm having a good green week, a good solid green week, which will finish also slightly in green today. Let's talk a little bit about some of my trades today. In fact, I don't want to get into details about the trade, the entry point, and you know how where exactly did I lose in both my Tesla and Boeing first trades. I just want to talk about the basics of trading, of expecting what the market will do, because the most important thing in day trading is to watch the S&P 500. We do that on the first lesson of the Star Trader course. If you have been with me during the first lesson of Star Trader course, you will know what kind of emphasis I would give to the S&P 500 and the way it moves. And the way to expect what the S&P 500 is doing is, in fact, the difference between making money or losing money most of the time, not all of the time. Because, you know, every stock that you take will move according to the S&P 500 60% of the time. And there's another 30% which has to do with the sector of the stocks that you're trading. And then approximately 10% which has to do when, you know, where the stock has a life of its own. Meaning 60% of the movement that you will expect in the stock that you trade, talking about Tesla and Boeing specifically today, has to do with the S&P 500. On the other hand, for example, I had a nice long trade in NIO today, which had one of its 10% days, right? So you need to know the difference between where the stock is going to move by its own, like NIO, for example, today. And we had a fantastic long trade in NIO today. On the other hand, you need to take a look at other stocks which are likely to move with the market, and that would be Tesla and Boeing. So I took a look at the daily of Tesla and Boeing today, and both of them look to me like they should come down. I'm just going to take a quick look with you at Boeing. Look at Boeing. It's trending lower, coming down, nice breakdown opportunity over here. Well, I really thought it's going to make a much bigger move, right? And Tesla looks quite the same. So in my opinion, both Boeing and Tesla should have moved down today. And they are. On the other hand, you need to start by looking at the S&P to expect when they will move down. First few minutes in the S&P, these are 5 minute candles. I took a look at the S&P, the first green candle, and then the second one was a topping candle. And then the third one came or really touched the lows. At that point, I thought, well, maybe we're going to have a gap and go. We started down 0.5%. Maybe it's going to continue coming down. It was a tough call to make. I wasn't sure about what's going to happen. So I took my first Boeing and Tesla trade as they were failing to move higher. So you see, Tesla started moving higher, failed. I took the trade for the short side. Boeing started to move higher, failed. The S&P failed, came down to the lows. Took the short trade. Boeing was supposed to come down and hopefully become a winner. It was not. Boeing moved over the highs, took me out. Tesla moved over the highs, took me out. So I started with both losing trades in Tesla and in Boeing. NIO came later. IBM was great, was a very nice gap and go trade, as you can see here. It just started with a big gap down and continued coming down, so it was really lovely. But my losers in Tesla and Boeing were bigger than my winner in IBM, therefore I started in red and in fact stayed red most of the day. But then, as you heard me say several times, when you see the market starting with a gap down and moving higher, and it did decide to move higher, that's why I had the losers in Boeing and in Tesla. So when you see the market starting to move higher. Don't expect this trend to continue. When the market is down 0.5%, it's a big gap. You know, a gap of 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, sometimes 0.5 and 0.6, but more rarely, will get closed in the S&P. But having a gap of 0.5 and expecting it to move up and close the gap, that will be a little bit more rare. So I was looking for the first sign of a pullback from the highs to prove to me that I was right. Because when you have the first pullback, there's two options here. One is just a small pullback and a continuation, and then the S&P would just move over the highs. The second one, which is more likely to happen, is the first sign of a pullback which will actually take you down and possibly under the lows, which is exactly what happened in the S&P. So when you see the first sign of a pullback, when the market already started with a gap down, don't expect a continuation in the direction of closing the gap. Expect a pullback that will take you down, I don't know how much. I mean, could stay around here. Right now you can see it's popping up a little bit. Could stay around here, could come under the lows, which it did, could continue coming under the lows. Not very likely, because it is a Friday and we usually don't have big moves on Friday. So whatever we did here was fine. And then Tesla did the same. So, you know, I felt like I chose the right stocks, like Tesla and Boeing, that they should both come down. So I had my second Tesla trade short and my second Boeing trade short. Tesla worked out much better. What worked out much better than IBM. That's why my end result in Tesla is a green trade, a very green trade. Boeing did not work out as good as Tesla, so I'm still red in Boeing, but Tesla brought me back to green territory. And of course, NIO at that time moved higher, so a small winner in NIO. And anyway, it all started with the S&P 500. You expect the market, when it has a big gap down, to move higher in the direction of closing the gap, but you expect a failure, which doesn't always come, but it comes more often. I mean, more than 60% of the time it will happen, or around 60% of the time it will happen. So, and then if you're ready for a short like Tesla or Boeing, then you should probably take the trade, because you know the daily looks like it should come down and so on. So my knowledge really helped me today to get back to green, and a little bit more than that, not much more than that. But this knowledge helped me to realize that my first two choice of shorting today, Tesla and Boeing, should in fact join the market. And again, 60% of the movement of the stocks that you're trading comes from the S&P 500. There's a lot of reasons to that. We're not going to get into this. We talk about it for a long time during the Star Trader course. But anyway, that helped me get back to green. Sometimes the analogy helps you be green or have a nice green day. Sometimes you're wrong. And sometimes, as it happened today, it just helped me get back to green territory. Thank you. Yeah, I saw some of the announcements here, especially on YouTube, talking about please don't take the second shot or things like that. You know, I don't know who's right, who's wrong, if that's going to work out or not, if that's going to be dangerous or not, taking gas the first or the second shot. But I think it is kind of our duty to take the risk here. Because, you know, I don't know about you, but there's a lot of things that I did not like about 2020. And really looking to get back my normal life in 2021. And I think that it's more likely to be okay. It's much more likely to be fine. I mean, the risk is probably there, but there's risk in everything that we do, right? And I think that calculating the risk right now and looking at the benefit, of course, I think it's the right time for all of us to take the vaccine. In my opinion, we should take it and put it behind us. And yes, of course, there's risk in everything we do. There's risk in the... I got an email from in day trading, of course. There's the bigger risk is, I would say, a person sent me an email, he said, it's a bigger risk to get married than to take the vaccine. I mean, right? You never know. You take the vaccine, you don't know what's coming next. You get married, you don't know what's coming next. Which one is more dangerous, right? I mean, let's have a poll. Which one do you think is more dangerous? Clifton, let's start a poll. The vaccine or getting married? I just wonder what... YouTube guys, what are you guys saying? Getting married? Well, we've got like 82% here in our room saying that getting married is is more dangerous than getting the vaccine. Well, we should sell this poll to Pfizer or to Moderna or to the other companies. I think it's an important poll, right? Nobody made this poll until now. Exactly, 80%. Well, traders, we had some fun. Thank you all. Thank you for joining. I'll see you all next week. Let's enjoy the weekend. And I'm sure we will be fine. Bye, guys.